Hey, hello, I'm Yolo. How was your day? Are you ready for some more Retopology action? Let's start today's session with the eyes. I'm pressing Shift plus A and adding a sphere. For the eyes, I'm usually doing 12 segments and 8 rings. And now the fun part, we don't have to try and match the low poly eye with the high poly one. We'll just copy the data from one to the other. Select your low poly eye and in the object constraint properties, add copy transforms. And select the high poly eye as a target. And it snapped right to the place we want. And to keep the eye in place, press Ctrl plus A and select visual transform. You can now delete the object constraint we used. But keep in mind that this won't work if you have applied transformations on the high poly eye earlier or moved its origin point. I'm adding an additional edge loop to the iris area and using smoothness to make the eye smoother and rounder. Next, we will make the main hair curl. I decided to make a somewhat complex implementation of this part. I want some part of this curl to be separated from the head so I can animate it. But I always like to start simple, so I duplicated the curl, reduced the resolution and converted it to a mesh. To do that, go to the object menu, choose convert and then mesh. Let's clean that. Oh nice, I remembered how to select loops here. Oh! By the way, you can do it like that. Select two edges and then press Ctrl plus Shift plus plus on your numpad, if you have it, that is. Then go to the Select drop-down menu, select Loops and Edge Loops or Edge Rings. The next thing I want to do is remove the back part of the curl. So I'm selecting and removing face loops one by one. I want to clean up that broken topology and merge it, so there is no hole in there. I'm selecting and merging vertice by vertice. Turning on snapping to faces and moving vertices. I want them to snap properly to high poly hair. Unfortunately, it didn't snap to the curve, so I had to convert high poly hair to mesh 2. And after that, snapping started working. To ensure that my low poly model completely covers the high poly hair, I'm also adding a shrink wrap modifier, choosing high poly mesh as a target and applying it. I want the top part of the low poly model to be merged with the main hair mass, but the bottom part should be a bit separated, so I'm snapping some vertices to the main hair model too. Okay, I'm closing up the curl's bottom part and at the same time I'm thinking about how to connect it to the main mesh. Let's leave it for now and work a bit on the main hair model. Continue working on the hair. I really want to finish the hair model today. At the bottom of the hair, I use the Strokes tool from the Retop Flow plugin. It gives you rows of polygons very fast. You just have to select the edge you want to continue and then holding Ctrl draw a second edge. Simple and nice! And now back to the curl part. I'm cutting out a hole exactly under the curl so that we can attach it later without any problems at all. To make it easier to work on attaching the curl to main mesh, I hit the back of the head by selecting those polygons and pressing the H hotkey. And we did it! We finished the hair! I hope you understood what I did with this curly hair part and why. If you still have any questions, be sure to ask them in the comments. I'll do my best to answer. The next part will probably be the last part on Retopology. See you very soon!